Hello, travelers. Welcome back. Since last time, Wanderman narrowly avoided death several times, turned abandoned relics into lifelines, and was nearing the end of his journey to find his son. Amidst the ruins and riddles, my journey is etched with echoes of life, a life once ordinary, now extraordinary in its quest for survival. With each sunrise, the nomad rises. Not just a survivor, but a keeper of humanity's fleeting flame. Now at the dawn of a new day upon us, the journey wades through untamed dangers. The old world comforts, a jar of maple syrup, the static hum of a television set. They anchor me to what I once was. The challenge beckons. To live, to thrive, to carve a new tale in this reclaimed land. This is the essence of a nomad. No looking back, only forward. Where our stories await to be told. Anyways, starting off day 5, I checked my map. We're basically just outside of West Point. A simple breakfast of cereal by the bike was more than enough nourishment for me. So I hopped on my bike and left the house that I stayed in. Each rotation was a churn of hope as I edge into the town. After pedaling for several minutes into the town of West Point, a car catches my eye. Sleek and silent, a ghost of the world before. I dismount, curious and hopeful, as the reality of travel by bike was wearing thin. The undead were there to greet me, but I swung my axe at them and cleared the way to what could be my new steed. I had entered the house by the car and found a moment's peace before looking for keys. My search bore no fruit. The car remained an unfulfilled promise, so we were stuck with the bike. I sought an alternative across the road, another car. Again, the dead arose. Their end was swift, and I showed them no mercy. Exhausted, I slumped into the driver's seat of the car, cereal in hand. No keys were found, but this was another good moment to catch my breath. The stress of all the blood on me was building up, so I cleaned up in the first house I had entered. And despite my temptation to sleep, I only rested, the fear of becoming too comfortable in one place gnawing at the back of my mind. The road called to me, so I set off once again, pedaling towards Louisville, promising new dangers and discoveries. An unexpected roadblock brought me to a jarring halt. A tangled mess of abandoned vehicles presented a new puzzle to solve, especially because I had gotten my bike stuck, so I had to wiggle my way out of that problem. I had paused on the open road, map in hand, and a tin of beans in the other. And after that, pedaled up the road for a little while. I turned off of the main road and searched for a sanctuary to rest in. The sight of a house caught my attention. Seeing zombies around, I braced myself for a fight, stepping off my bicycle. The undead were quick to greet me, but I was quicker, clearing the property with precise, lethal swings. Once inside, I went through the familiar routine of securing doors and windows, turning a once chaotic space into a temporary haven. The second, smaller house by the van also needed to be cleared. Thankfully, there were no surprises there, but it wasn't the first house that yielded a true prize. A set of van keys casually resting on a shelf. A small victory, but in this world, every bit counted. I assessed the van's condition. It wasn't pristine, but it was certainly serviceable. Now inside, I let the sink water wash over me as I rinsed the day's grime and blood off of my skin. And with the night drawing near, I took to the nearby trees with an axe. Why, you may ask? Well, perhaps driven by instinct to prepare for darker days, it was to craft a campfire kit. I placed my new campfire next to an already existing campfire for some reason. Maybe a sign of dominance, but definitely a sign that Wanderman has been here. The twin fires flickered to life, and for a moment, there was a light in the darkness. I picked up a guitar from a previous shelter, but unfortunately, I didn't know how to use it and held it in the completely wrong way. So I sat down by the fire and took a second to relax. I went inside, ate some food, and became extremely tired. I yielded to the fatigue, hoping the fires would ward off the evil creatures for the night. Of course, peace was never guaranteed and woke up to the sound of a gunshot. Noise had gathered some undead outside, so I had to fend them off. And after killing them, the van needed some fuel. Thankfully, I had some tanks laying around, so I poured some into the van. It was able to turn on, so I attached the trailer to it. Afterwards, it was time to set off to Louisville. The road was uncertain, but every mile was a victory, and every turn, a new possibility. Driving for a while, we hit a roadblock. A cruel barrier. But desperation led to innovation, and by that I mean I lured the dead away just enough to get back in the van and make my escape. I quickly realized the van would not work, and I returned to my bike, the only true companion of my nomadic lifestyle. Although, fate, it seemed, was not done with me yet. The horde, like a relentless tide, followed me there. Outnumbered and outmaneuvered, I ran. Survival wasn't about heroics, it was about knowing when to fight and when to flee. I jumped into a random house, but at this point was exhausted. I ran through it, hopped the fence of another house, then had to kill some more zombies. Found another small home and found a moment of reprieve. I could rest, reflect, and prepare for the next leg of my journey. Dawn greeted me, so I cleaned up ate what I could, and steeled my nerves. The new day came no respite. Stepping outside, the harsh reality was immediate. A fight for existence resumed. The undead were relentless, but I was resolved to survive. Bodies of the fallen littered the ground, silent testimonies to the struggle. Amongst the chaos, I found my bike, its form mirroring my weariness, laying flat on the ground. I flipped the bike over and got to work, attaching it to the trailer. It was a lifeline for me, an escape from the persistent clutches of doom. So I went back to the small house to recover my stamina before leaving, preparing for a journey that lay ahead. So, with the shroud of night as my cloak, ventured towards Louisville. Also, I apparently spent 30 real-life minutes trying to go around the gate and find another entrance. I failed. And so, undeterred, I returned down the path I went on, to the main road to the town. I had a new plan this time, so I took the railway, hoping for a stealthier path somewhere. It was a vein leading straight to the city's edge, ridden with risk and opportunity. I found some kind of gate, but accidentally crashed into the booth, and unfortunately, a large amount of undead were drawn to it. So began the sacred dance of training the zombies away from it. After a minute, I got back on the bike and followed the gate's edge, and spotted a crack in the fortress. Of course, the bike was quite stubborn and barely moved off-road. Only through sheer willpower and minute movements did we traverse the opening. I had found myself near a campsite after breaking through the hole in the fence. I killed some undead near the site, reclaiming a small piece of land for myself. Then, I found another bike, but it really wasn't any better. The trailer just had too much weight to provide solid mobility. I was tired, so I surrendered to the exhaustion and slept in a tent for the night. Dawn brought no relief, and the bike, laden and uncooperative, refused to move. Only after the nearby dead were dispatched could I attempt to leave the area. Unfortunately, there was a miscalculation. A bite to the neck and hand. Panic surged as blood spewed out everywhere. I had to flee for a second and hastily bandaged my wounds. The last of my aggressors fell, but victory was pyrrhic. My vitality was halved, my body a testament to the brutality of survival. Wounded but undeterred, I mounted my bike and made my escape. Greed got the better of me, and I saw a better looking bike. Yet, what awaited me was not fortune, but a very large amount of zombies. My only chance of survival was to bait and lure them away from the bike. I had to fight for my life, for what felt like an eternity. In the end, the horde was insurmountable. I had no choice but to abandon my trailer, seizing the new bike in a desperate bid for life. Briefly, further down the road, I made a spot to gather my breath. After a second of rest, I biked down the road, but with my stamina waning and in severe pain, I leaped over a fence to find safety, only to find more trouble. Hindsight mocked my choices as I stumbled into a fresh hell. I was a nervous wreck, exhausted, gotten bit, almost died, and had to run for my life. Jumping over another fence, I killed a zombie. Tried to regain my stamina, but unfortunately had no time. Thankfully, I got a chance to rebandage myself here. I went to the house, hoping to get inside, but zombies blocked my path, so I ran. Finding another house to get into, I tried to lose them, but was not successful. Desperation led me through doors meant to keep out danger, only to find that danger was always one step behind and one step away from my end. I spent the next 3 hours running for my life, through open roads, forests, and neighborhoods. Somehow, I survived, even though I was severely tired, extremely exhausted, terrified, sick, depressed, a nervous wreck, thirsty, in extreme pain, and hot. I then found a house to lock myself into. Within its confines, I attended to my needs. Hunger, thirst, and most importantly, rest. After resting, I took some time to rebandage myself. And of course, amidst the fleeting silence, an infection took hold. There was an insidious enemy within, sapping my strength, threatening to end the nomadic lifestyle I've worked so hard to secure. Creaks and moans of the undead filled the building as I left the room. Clearing it was the only option. I then rinsed myself off. Even with fresh bandages, my life's essence ebbed away. I now knew my days were numbered. The ground floor had a ton of undead, so my only escape method was to jump out a window from the top floor. I then found a pink bicycle, and for some reason, the bell wouldn't stop going off. Noise attracted tons of the dead, so I had no choice but to abandon it. I sought the familiarity of my old bike, and after a few minutes, found it and pedaled off towards my son's location. I found a house, silent and seemingly untouched, and I broke in. There were some undead inside, but I secured it. Cleansing the grime from my body, I prepared for rest, seeking solace in sleep. I woke up. The infection gnawed at my insides, a grim reminder that my quest was one against time itself. With urgency lending speed, I hopped onto my bike, driven by the need to find my son before the end. Unfortunately, the sickness sapped my strength, forcing me to abandon the bike, and I had to walk instead. Breaking into another haven, I sought rest, but the undead were persistent, forcing me to keep moving. After a moment, I found myself in a house and confirmed with my map the location I needed to go to. I left and not long after found a taxi. Remember those keys I grabbed on day one? Yeah, those would actually be useful because the taxi had gas in it. Now a vessel of hope, the engine sparked to life, and I drove towards what I hoped would be a reunion. The house stood silent and boarded up, a fortress against the world, the opposite of my ideals, but nevertheless I broke in, searching for my son. But there was nothing, no laughter, no warmth, just silence. Numb, I found an ice-cold beer in the fridge, so I put on my visor, a reminder of normalcy in a world that had none left to give. And with the infection reaching its conclusion, I wasn't gonna go down without a fight. I found some ammunition, guns, and food, a nomad's last stand. And so, Wanderman, a father, a survivor, a man of the post-apocalypse, met the end as he lived. A true nomad to the very end. Project Zomboid is often cruel, a relentless gauntlet in an apocalyptic world. The Nomad's journey is never about the destination, but about the tales etched into every mile traveled. Wanderman was surely the embodiment of a reckless adventurer, never unscathed, but never undefeated in spirit. Though Wanderman's mission reached its end, his story echoes in the silence in this world. He didn't find what he sought, but perhaps he found things along the way that were just as important. Maybe it's the unyielding hope. Maybe it was the ambition to find greater heights. Maybe it was the late night maple syrup. And so I lay down the mantle of Wanderman. His journey concludes not with a reunion, but with a legacy he leaves behind. And until the end of days and beyond, the visor of hope will push forward. And to those who followed this challenge, your companionship was the beacon that shone through the darkest nights. I am Celico, thanks for bearing witness to the story of Wanderman. And the answer is yes, you can survive as a nomad and probably longer than him. If you like Project Zomboid videos, be sure to like and subscribe for more. Until next time, fellow travelers.